Namaste everyone. Today we are going to dissect a hibiscus flower and see the reproductive parts in it. A hibiscus flower. The first thing that I am going to do is I am going to remove this outer layer, which is green in color. This is called sepals. They protect the petals. Now very slowly I am going to remove this green part. The sepals protect the bud and the flower is in the bud state. Can you see? I have removed all the sepals. Now I am going to slowly remove the petals, which are red in color. They help in attracting the insects, which help in pollination. Can you see? I have removed all the petals and the sepals. Now, what we see here is the female reproductive and the male reproductive part of the hibiscus flower. Now, can you see this yellow part, the yellow thing here? These are called the anthers. They are the male part of the flower. The anther and the filament is right here. They produce pollens. The male reproductive part consists of two parts, the anther and the filament. Now, can you see this long tube-like structure? This is the female reproductive part. We have this style. The red part here is the stigma, and this, the hip part here, is called the ovary. Ovary consists of the ovules. Now slowly I am going to slit this open so that we can see the ovules. Now slowly if I open this here, you can see the small ovules here. Now, can you see here? The yellow part here inside the ovary are the ovules. The ovules become what? The seeds in the future, and the ovary becomes the fruit. So now today we have understood that a flower, a hibiscus flower, consists of both the male and the female reproductive parts of a flower. Hibiscus flower consists of both the male and the female reproductive parts. Now the flower which consists both the male and the female reproductive parts are called the perfect flower. So we can say that a hibiscus flower is a perfect flower. During the dissection of the hibiscus flower today, we could see the different parts of a flower: the petals, the sepals, the male reproductive part, which had the anther and the filament, and the female reproductive part, which had the style, stigma, ovary, and also the ovules. So now we have understood that the flower is the main part of the plant where we get the fruit and the seeds. So, today children, we learned that the flower is the most attractive part of a flowering plant. It plays a very important role in producing seeds and giving rise to similar baby plants. Now, you also can try to do this activity. If possible, get a hibiscus or a lily flower and see for yourself these different parts of the flower. And you can come back and share your experiences in our next class. Bye-bye. See you in the next class.